So the Coors line, is that licensed from the Coors beer in the U.S.?
That's correct.
Mm. So you actually do produce foreign brands as well?
That's correct.
Mm. Now, what would be the beer with the highest alcohol content?
The highest alcohol content would be Polk 45, which has 7.2% alcohol by volume.
7.2%. How do you make a beer that strong?
We use the technology where we push the fermentation of the alcohol as much as possible, and we concentrate the alcohol via the fermentation process.
Mm.
And then based on the fermentation, the alcohol is generated by the yeast.
Yeah.
The attenuation is very, very high.
Mm. And when you push it, does that mean that you go beyond the normal 19-day fermentation process?
No, it's following the same production process, except that formation of the alcohol is done through the reaction of the yeast.
Mm-hmm.
So it's quite fermented, highly fermented product.
Mm. And it's the breakdown of the sugars, right?
That's correct.
In the product that comes out with the alcohol content in each beer.
That's correct.
Mm-hmm. So if you wanted to make more alcohol and you just push the fermentation process, does that mean adding more yeast?
No, the hydrolysis reaction, or what we call the process of converting the sugar to the alcohol, is dependent on the amount of enzyme that is generated during the mashing process.
Mm.
And fermentation is pushed by the yeast.
Yeah.
There's some limitation in the sense that there's so much sugar that can be released by the enzymatic process.
Mm.
We can concentrate the alcohol by producing more extract in there, but
yeah.
It becomes undrinkable because it becomes too heavy.
It becomes poison.
It's just too heavy. It's very heavy in the stomach, and it's not pleasant anymore.
Actually, for a brewmaster, and you have a beer like Colt 45 that has
7.2%
alcohol, would anything beyond 7.2%, as you say, become too heavy and becomes undrinkable, or is there something much higher than that you can still produce?
We can still produce it, but the fermentation process would have to be much, much longer.
More than 19 days.
More than 19 days, mm. And you can leave it there for a month.
Mm.
In fact, there are products like that in existence in other parts of the world.
Oh, okay. And that's something that Asian Brewery is not planning to make.
It's not part of our program right now.
Mm. But unless somebody, or there's a market for it.
But if there's a demand, we will do it.
Mm.
It's just a matter of finding what the consumers want.
Mm. All right. Now let's go to the opposite spectrum of the brewing process. Of course, they say there's a giant brewery. There are micro-breweries. Pivo Praha is just one of them. How many actually micro-breweries are there in the country today, Joel?
What I know is we are the only one right now operating.
Mm-hmm.
But the Indusit Hotel, there's the same level, but I don't know if it's still operating right now.
So you believe that you're the only microbrewery now in existence?
Yeah.
Judith, wow. How long has Pivo Praha been around?
Since 2001.
Okay, kinabahan ako doon. By hesitating, akala ko you're going to say since the ancient times or something. Pivo Praha is obviously not an English term. Where did it come from?
From Czech Republic.
The Czech Republic. Are the Czechs known for making good beers?
Yeah.
Yeah? Mm-hmm. Exactly what kind of world-renowned beers do they make?
Actually, we have that four kinds,
mm-hmm.
the four flavors.
Yeah.
The Weizen, the dark, the classic, mm-hmm. and the light.
Okay.
So, here in the Philippines, the most saleable is the classic and the Weizen.
Classic and Weizen. All right, let's begin with the classic.
Yeah.
What makes it a classic?
Yeah, the classic. Here, you see the classic? Yeah. Right. I have some of. The classic is the original Czech classic Pilsen beer with a strong hop bitterness and malt.
Ah, okay.
Yeah. And then the Weizen naman is the taste is like a ripe banana. So most women like it.
Oh, women like banana.
That's
a surprise.
That is, yeah.
I mean, there's no reaction from the women in the audience tonight. But anyway, what? Not a surprise. Joel, come up with one. Why do women like banana flavored beer?
Because of its aroma and the taste. So it came from the general fermentation process.
Okay.
We have the much higher temperature, mm-hmm. and the byproduct of that is the taste and the aroma.
What's the formula or the technique that you're using now in Pivo Praha taken from any Czech formula, or did you develop it locally?
No, from Czech Republic.
Yeah. He studied in Czech Republic.
Ah, I see.
For brewer.
How do you say Lahin Laho in Czech?
I don't know.
All right.
I know is cheers.
Lahin Laho from Rada, anyway. Cheers. What do you say? How do you say cheers in
Czech? Debus Tresti.
Again?
Debus Tresti.
Debus Tresti. How do you say cheers in Asia Brewery?
Mabuhay!
All right.
Tagay.
Tagay. Tagay pa. All right. So, microbreweries, do they require, you know, a stricter kind of procedure than, like, bigger breweries like Asia Brewery?
It's almost the same.
Mm-hmm. And the difference is only in the quantity of beer that you produce. The quantity of beer.
Shorter process.
Because they have 19 days, right, for the fermentation process. How much shorter is it for a microbrewery?
6 to 7 days.
6 to 7 days. Mm-hmm. Oh, why does it take a shorter period for a microbrewery?
Because we only have a small amount of work,
mm-hmm.
and we pitch in the yeast.
Mm-hmm. So a limited quantity calls for a shorter fermentation period.
In a month, I think it's 3,000 liters long, no?
All right, now here's a question that both Pivo Praha and Asia Brewery should probably answer, because if there are going to be proposed laws to limit the alcohol intake of people who will be driving, do you think that both of you should be coming out with beers that will be either non-alcoholic or have lower alcohol content?
I think it's a matter of preference. You can reduce your beer intake, and basically, if you abstain, you don't drink beer, then you just give up the pleasure of drinking beer.
But what if you still want to drink? Is there a product that Asia Brewery or Pivo Praha can come up that will allow you to imbibe and yet still be safe?
The current product that would fit the description would be Coors Light, which has only a 4.1% alcohol.
Mm-hmm.
You can maintain your pace and not get drunk, because the metabolism of your body is getting rid of the alcohol as fast as you're imbibing the product, as long as you don't pump down the beer consecutively.
So you can take as many as how many in an hour and not be affected?
Actually, based on studies, the body can metabolize the alcohol of the regular beer.
Yeah.
One bottle of beer would keep you sober all night long.
Oh, okay.
It's not so bad. It's just a matter of the intake that you do.
And Pivo Praha, you already have a light beer, right?
Yeah.
And that is how much alcohol content?
4%.
4%. Do you have any idea or plan to come up with a lower alcohol content for your beer, if in case they pass the new law on drunk driving?
Right now, there's none.
Okay. So Pivo Praha will still be for
4%.
4%. All right. Well, thanks very much to our guest, Dr. Rivera, the brewmaster from Asia Brewery, and to Joel Loresco and Judith Argonza from Pivo Praha. What's the cheers again in Czech?
Debus
Tresti. And Tagay from Asia Brewery. All right. Thank you very much, our guest. Coming up next, if we can still keep our eyes straight, a look at Sony's 3D offerings. Keep it logged on to Future Purpose.